Hey guys, WC Hamill here, and I'm back on the new Riador 1.11 survival server. Uh-oh, here it goes. Already, these guys have been driving me crazy. This video is being recorded before the other one is being uploaded. I actually rendered the video that you will have seen before this one like 2 days ago, and I just like didn't upload it for some reason. I went to bed, it rendered, it was done, and then I just like forgot and put it in the folder, so I need to do that. But in the meantime, before we get too far along, I wanted to show you some of the stuff that I've done since then. I just finished up the walls, which is all this that you can see here. No, don't shoot me again. All that you can see there. I raided the other temple that was nearby, that second one over there, to get the rest of this dark prismarine so I could just do it. Just finish the stupid walls and the stupid border and get all of it done. And I also tested this out right here. And you might remember when I said something about like, oh, it's 7777, so it makes it easy. Well, I forgot the water actually flows 8 blocks. And since it goes over the edge, like it counts as 1 there. So it's like every single one of these is like 8. So this one should have been 8, which would put a 2x2. And I don't want a 2x2. I didn't want signs either. I wanted it to flow and match nicely. But you can't always get what you want. I guess I could make this ring, you know, take this down one level, and then take this block down one, take this block down one, and then this will just flow to here and go over and not quite be the full length of travel, but I don't want to do that. Yeah. So, yeah. Basically, the idea now is that I'm going to place water in the corners, and if I've done this correctly, because I used to do it where I would just place the water like this. I wouldn't have these. This is kind of like how you do the iron golem farms, you know, to keep it from joining, because what we don't want is a bunch of source blocks. But yeah, see, that's nice. That's not gonna cover us. So let's see. Go ahead and take this down to the middle, because we want to see if this actually works. So 1, 2, skip a few. There we go. Let's just... I think this might spawn guardians. I'm hoping it doesn't, because it's going to be annoying if it does. But, okay, yeah. See, it goes over the edge, but it's luckily it's only one... It's one thing, so that sign will stop it. They'll still flop around, but they can fall through here, and that's all we need, you know? So, fine. I'm fine with it. It's fine. Everything's fine. So, I knew I didn't get all of it. I thought I did, for sure, but whoops. So I need to put some bone blocks there, and that'll be done. After we get this section in place, we can remove the dirt, but I don't necessarily, well, I mean, I guess it doesn't really matter, but I've been using this as a way up and down because it's safe, quote unquote safe. Because you can get into the water like this. You don't have to swim through these guys. There's still quite a lot of water on the outside of the temple. And this allows you to go through all the dry bits. Bits and pieces. But, you know, whatever. It's fine. And, oh, here we go. This is what I've been working on out here. This exit. Whoops. So I've gotten a lot of the outside cleared up. I've had some help. But a lot of this I've done myself. I put on put on some music. I got some what was it? What was I listening to? I was listening to Queen and something else, so like David Bowie or something. So been just putting music on, listening, placing down sand, placing down sponges, taking the sponges down, taking the sand down, moving it over, and then also placing all the blue glass on the outside wall. So if anybody gets to the outside and you're like, oh, how do I know if I've you know, if this is the last wall of sand or not. Well, the answer is that dark ring of prismarine. So if you are out here helping me and don't know, that's your clue. But if you're really not sure, don't dig it out. Because I don't want the water to flood back in from the ocean and cause a huge mess. But yeah, this is the next section we're going to be doing. You can see, let's just close this. Javadav is out here and he was helping clear out some of this water. He's putting doors everywhere. So now we've got a nice pathway that goes all the way around the side of the building. So it's good. You can go all the way around out here. But yeah, I'm going to get to work clearing out more of this water. I may do it in the live stream this weekend We'll see if I have time. I think I want to try and do some of that Saturday. It'd be nice. I haven't live streamed in a while. So if you're seeing that, you're going to see this after that would have happened. So if it did, thanks for stopping by and watching it. If I didn't, don't worry about it. You didn't miss anything because I didn't do it. So, but yeah, I got a lot of clearing out to do. So that should be a good one. All right, that took way longer than needed to. I only had 20 blocks, so I had to go craft up another. I didn't need a stack, but it's just easier to do it that way. So I could fill in that last little bit right over there. So let's see. Let me show you this. I dropped. Ooh, yes. See? Haha. You thought I was going to perish, but I did not. Down there, you can see the hoppers that go into a chest for to collect resources from Death of Guardians. But right now it's not working because I haven't done it yet. that'll be soon. But I put in this little safety net of the slime blocks to keep players from meeting an untimely end. So I don't know if guardians spawn in running water. I haven't seen any yet. And if they don't, then that's great. But if they do, it's not a huge deal. But I was just thinking it might be easier. I just wonder if it'd be easier to remove the dirt without these, but then I'm gonna have a bunch of stupid guardian guys just flopping around lasering me. So I think what I'm gonna do is just like go ahead and bucket this all out, you know, and make sure the water flows like I want to, collect all the torches, and then from then on, I'm gonna move the drop shaft so that it's working properly. And we're going to not use that as a way down anymore. We're just going to use the workshaft as its intended function is. So, yeah, you know, this is going to take a little bit, but I will soldier through it because it's for the good of the warehouse. That's why we're doing all this, so we can get materials so I can build the warehouse floor and finish it. Jeez. I just heard one flopping around and I saw it go down there. So as it turns out, they do spawn in there. It's just we've got so many down underneath still and so many upstairs still because this is all new water. We're not going to have a lot of luck getting them, but you know, good to know, I guess. I should probably, well, I guess it doesn't really matter. Yeah, I should probably put some ladders there just in case so we don't have any kind of Don't want any trouble with these locals here. Yeah, I see if we can listen out for him, but it should be that guy should be alive, because it's not that far of a drop, and I think they are pretty resilient. It's getting awfully dark in here. Where do I need this? This side. Yeah, what's it? Oh, yep, flipping and flop. I see him. Oh crap, he can get out. Okay. Well, we need to be careful then. This is almost done, and then we can block it off and no more visitors to this lower section. Everything's working. Look at this. I made a thing and it's correct. Ooh. That guy can jump. Look how high they can go up. Oh, this could be a game. Oh, he died. They can go ladders? I'm learning so much stuff today. Get. Where is he? Oh, okay. So they might eventually die because of hitting that thing. So that's good. That's good. Good, good, good. Yeah, so let's climb out of here. Look at this. Oh, we've got squid. Oh, man. Oh, man. Oh, buddy. So, we're going to take this down now. Here, at least to here. This will give us a path through, and then it'll still give us a path down. That's fine, and we don't need this anymore. Take that. Give these guys a chance to fall to their deaths. But yeah, so now we have a chance of collecting mob drops and things. People are gonna swim down here, and stuff is gonna happen, and it's gonna be great. Oh, I guess I can close that up then too. All right, well, cool. We've got some progress going. I love it. So at some point in this unreasonably overwhelming amount of time that I've spent just trying to clear the water out of this monument. I realized I think I've been doing this the hard way. Yeah, these guys are just a mess, and they won't leave me alone even for a minute, which I guess is understandable. I'm ruining their habitat in order to make a machine designed specifically to annihilate them repeatedly. But still, you know, come on, work with me a little bit here, guys. Get out of my way. I'm trying to do progress. This is innovation. This is industry. You know, you're standing in the way of industry. But yeah, this is tedious to say the least. And, you know, I wouldn't have it any other way. Or if I knew of another way, I might actually do it that way. But I don't, so, you know, we're stuck with it. Yeah, I have gone probably 3/4 of the way around getting all this stuff. I had a crazy weekend. Not the fun kind of crazy weekend. My cat was in the cat hospital, which was not good. Luckily, she's okay. She spent 3 days in there in the vet and trying to get diagnosed, see what was wrong. She was throwing up a lot and having all these issues, wouldn't eat. So they had her on IVs and then steroids and stuff. They were afraid that she may have swallowed something, but as it turns out, it may have just been she got a hold of something and just ate something that irritated her insides. So good and bad. You know, I don't want my little kitty to be upset, but it's good to have her back home. But yeah, that kind of threw off my whole digging schedule and sand removal processes. Ooh, this is still not done. Whoops. As you can see, I am a little flustered at the moment. Yes, I picked the right wall. One of these walls is not like the others and should not be removed. Actually, oh, these both can come down. Great, so that means I can clear out underneath. Yeah, the ultimate plan of this, once I get all this water on the outside of the removed, is that I have to get all the stuff on the underside of the temple. So what I'll do is end up actually just removing the temple all the way to the ground floor. And then once I remove the ground floor, then I'll just drop sand and probably fill the rest in. I don't know if I want to do the sponges anymore. There's so much work. But yeah, it's coming along nicely, I think. You know, despite all the setbacks, we are still soldiering forward with this one section at a time, and it is looking nice. All right, it's finally done. Well, when I say done, I mean the part where they can spawn in. Apparently, I found out that Guardians can't spawn below the temple, so that water is fine where it is. But it's not fine where it is, because that takes away from the aesthetic that I was going for. But for now, hey, look, it's Rika and Petty. But yeah, so for now, this is what we're going to do. So the next part of this journey, and I think probably the final part of this episode, is going to be ripping out this temple and just kind of getting a base going for this. And maybe, you know what? Why don't we get it kick-started? So we're gonna put in a couple more killing mechanics and make it a little bit easier to get these guys, because they can go down the ladder and all this kind of junk. So we'll get it working. We'll open up the top and start these guardians flowing to their demise. the last few blocks to be picked up and placed into my inventory. And there we go. Oh, whoops. Oh, that one despawned. Perfect. Yeah, so we'll just ignore that. That was the last few. So now this is all that remains of the water temple down here. Ocean monument. Oop. Just gonna light up the floor, and as you can see, there's still water down underneath there. I'm going to clear it out. I was informed by Petty just a minute ago. He was like, "Hey, dummy, guardians can't spawn under there. You don't have to remove it." I was like, "Oh." He didn't call me a dummy. I was just kidding. But I was like, "Oh, didn't know that." Because there always have been a bunch of guardians down there, so I just figured they spawned. But apparently that was just like they swam around. So once that's why there were so many in this area, where it was the last section that I had to clear out, because they couldn't go anywhere. So they were just stuck, because I had walled it off. So now I know. But I still want to clear it out underneath here, and I'm still going to drop sand every four blocks in rows down here so that I can get... so I can get to the gravel and make my ultimate aquarium look thing going. So, yeah. Got some more work to do, but it is technically in the range of being, like, functional. Now, there's caves, there's, you know, other areas that may be able to spawn mobs around, and that will decrease my chances of spawning guardians and then of the, you know, the mob cap and all this kind of stuff. But I'm not so worried about it because this isn't designed to be super efficient. It's just designed to kill guardians right there in front of my very eyes. After all the damage they've put me through, look at my armor. Oh, well, it's not really that broken, but the point remains that they shall fall to their doom through here and through this little donut hole up here. But I think I will add some lava just to make it go a little bit quicker, because it's going to take a while. Yeah. So with that in mind, I think I'm going to go head upstairs and open it up. Oh, yeah. I went and got lava. It's right here in my inventory. And I was looking down here. I was like, okay. Everybody says I should put lava down there. Make them. But you know what? I'm not going to do lava. And you know why? Because... despite my having built an amazing squid farm before at the warehouse, I need more than that. So, instead, we're gonna let them, like, so if they get lasered up here, their drops, the squid ink drops, will just fall down. That's what I want. So this is the hardest part, right here in the middle, and I'm not even in the middle yet. Oh gosh, this is gonna be very difficult. Especially if they start shooting at me. Fall down. Yes. Yeah, this is the beginning, you guys. This is what we've been working towards this whole time. Making sure that we get amazing things. I'm trying not to accidentally open any of these fence gates. I worked really hard to get them all pointed the same direction. Ah! Yeah, and then just getting these goofuses to drop down, die, and, you know, give me all of their belongings in the process. This should hopefully not be too much of a difficult situation that I'm in right now. We shall see. It's working! It's working! Ha ha! But yes, thank you guys so much for watching. This has been an adventure. And we're getting there. We're so close. We just got to do these walls. We got to do underneath and some other stuff. There's still actually a lot to do, but yes, it is finally functional after only 2 episodes. Interesting. So I want to thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for all your comments, your support, your feedback, and I hope to see you all in the next episode. Bye.